remembers the lady who drank fish tank cleaner, right?
Right. Oh, yes. Yeah. Yes.
Koi pond cleaner. I didn't say poi.
Oh,
koi pond cleaner.
You,
you remember the story that we heard?
Right.
The story that we all heard and was covered in most major news outlets, both on television and publications, right, was that she heard a press briefing from Donald Trump touting the benefits of chloroquine.
It's medication.
Which is medication, can be prescribed by a doctor. Therefore, because she trusted everything Donald Trump said, she and her husband, they both drank it, and he died, unfortunately, a tragedy. She didn't. And then she had some words on mainstream media for everyone else. This was the story. This is how it was covered. Let's go to the clip.
Did you see the president's press conference? Where did you hear about?
Yeah, we saw that. We saw his press conference. It was on a lot, actually.
And then what? And then what? Did you seek out chloroquine?
I had it in the house because I used to have koi fish.
What would be your message to the American?
Should kill those too?
Oh my God! Don't take anything. Don't believe anything the president says.
Okay, so here's the thing, and I want, let me make a case. Some of this is absolutely 100% true that we have an, and then I will offer my opinion, okay? The truth is we know that it's a sham that she hates President Donald Trump, right? So at the very least, this was a fake story on that front. So you probably already know, and I am going to be looking down to make sure that I get this correctly. She was obviously a prolific Democrat donor. She donated to Hillary Clinton in 2016. We were able to confirm her identity and these reports. Okay, this has been released publicly, something I haven't seen covered anywhere else, though I don't know that nowhere else has covered it. She specifically donated to nonprofits that were progressive sort of science nonprofits. Huh. Basically, if you read their mission statement, it was, the agenda, the mission was to counteract the anti-science agenda, the anti-medicine agenda of the conservative right.
I thought it was to make
like chloroquine,
cleaner.
You know, like chloroquine, clinical trials. So you know that. What you don't know, okay, and is exclusive here. The same woman, I think we have an overlay here on social media, called President Trump a psycho prez. Okay, she called him a psycho president. And she has a history of violent behavior. Okay, so this idea is, you know, you're picturing her, the media has presented her as a pro-Trump middle American, right? She just trusted Trump, and her husband were drinking fish tank cleaner, holding each other like the couple in Titanic. When the truth is, she wanted to divorce her husband. Okay, so when she was discussing divorcing her husband in 2001, she attacked him, was arrested, was charged with domestic abuse assault, though eventually she was found not guilty. She still talked about wanting to divorce him in 2012 and said, quote, "I am furious all the time." Huh. She reiterated it in a 2013 court case. Now, some of this has been tweeted out, okay? Some of this information has been tweeted out, but we were able to confirm some of these other sources with two separate sources, okay? Yeah. One of them being a lawsuit that people sort of covered, but they missed the assault case where she filed against a company, I believe it was John Deere Tractor, where she worked for before. I don't know exactly why she sued them, but that's where the assault was mentioned because her real name wasn't used in any of the stories.
There we go.
Okay. And then the other one is we have some exclusive access to social media, and I had this corroborated with some folks in law enforcement. I looked it up. So she filed for I know when she filed for bankruptcy, some information that's not necessarily relevant, but it did serve to confirm this case. Now, here's the deal. We made sure to try and redact all the names. I obviously don't want to dox anyone. No. So please, nobody out there, try and dox or figure anything out. But the media knows this woman's name.
Yeah.
So they went out and they didn't cover her name. They just covered the story. This lady who was a President Trump supporter drank fish tank cleaner because Donald Trump is praising an unverified, unproven, not antibiotic, what is it? I guess an antiviral?
Something.
It's antimalarial, so it'd be antiviral, right?
Yeah.
He's been basically touting the benefits of this anti-coronavirus drug. The story was poor old lady and husband who love each other and love Trump die. The media, meaning New York Times, ABC, NBC, by the way, I'm going to be calling every single one of them after this show. So I want you to send in numbers, heads of news, people who you think would be in charge of these stories or who ran these stories, because they knew this woman's name.
Yeah.
They claim they were withholding it due to you know, wanting to keep her anonymous, in which case they knew that she wanted to divorce her husband. They knew that she hated President Donald Trump, and they knew that at least part of this was a sham, and that is journalistic malpractice. or ABC, NBC, CBS, all of these major news outlets, Washington Post, didn't know her name, in which case you did not verify or vet your anonymous source, which is journalistic malpractice. Yep. And you did this to try and alter the face of an election, by the way, because that's been the central issue, that Donald Trump hasn't handled this properly. And this was a linchpin for a lot of it. He's going out there making, here's Donald Trump, anti-science again. And you found a woman who gave to Hillary Clinton and gave to conservatives or anti-science nonprofits and something else, okay? So all of this we know, beyond any shadow of a doubt right now, was a sham to try and harm the president and by proxy all conservatives. But, do you know what else this means? This is speculation. This is speculation. I think this bitch is the new Carol Baskin. I think that this woman, think about it for a second.
I agree.
She was abusive toward her husband, a long history of it. She wanted to divorce him. She clearly hated Trump, and only her husband died? I think he was having his evening Manhattan and didn't realize that it was mixed with a little bit of koi food.
Well, I think what she did is she walked over and said, hey, honey, I already took my dose. It's time for yours.
Yes, exactly.
You know? No, and so there, I think
like a suicide pact.
Yeah. Right.
She broke the martini. And off, his wasn't.
Off the side of the mouth, and she didn't actually swallow it. So and the only reason that we're digging into something like this is that this story, on its face, made no sense whatsoever, right?
Well, no, that's...
Donald Trump was not pitching that people should be taking chloroquine, right? So that was a fact. He was just saying that that is something that might be beneficial. These people could not possibly have come up with the crazier story like, yeah, we both drank fish tank cleaner because it had one ingredient in it, much less everything else in it, that we thought might help us. None of these things really lined up. That's why we're digging into it, because it's just it just doesn't make sense anybody to do this.
And I think it's an absurd story, and it's really sad that her husband died. But here's, can you imagine if there was even a whiff of an idea that someone killed his wife in order to indict Barack Obama? Let's say a man came out and said, you know, I really supported Barack Obama, and I believed that he didn't have a brother who was in Kenya to live in a shanty. I didn't believe that until that man showed up and poisoned my wife. And now I think you shouldn't vote for Barack Obama. And then we find out that he poisoned his wife. You know, I'm not saying that's the case, but I do think there should actually be some kind of an investigation here for criminal activity. I don't know if it's not only fraud, but speculation, potential murder. I think it's really, really fishy. And I want everyone out there to blast this as far as you can. Send me on Twitter, at S. Crowder, any stories that you've seen or watched. Well, seen or watched, same thing. Yeah. Seen or read, I meant. Yeah. So watched or read. Sorry, I'm very tired, and I almost shat myself. who've covered this story, because I am going to run down a list and call each and every one of them.
Yes.
And find out which version of journalistic malpractice was at play here, because it is one or the other. And hopefully someone will follow this trail and see what happened to the husband.